thoughts and progress on the topology of real singularities.
Okay, thanks. So I decided to set such practice to find any one of that you got. So I decided to use such type because I didn't find any testing one, but maybe after the help, you know, to give you a better clue. So anyway, so thanks for the organizer, the scientific committee as well, to give me the opportunity to talk about my scientific progress. It's a joy to work with Ying Chen, Nicholas Perry, Mike Barr, and Andrade. And so, let me tell some few words about Pepe. First time I had the pleasure to find to meet him, it was in 1999, I think. So when I started my PhD project on the CGM orientation, and from that time CGM gave me an interesting challenge because she was building a preprint with Pepe and Bergovsky about the first example, I think, of mapping satisfying some the minimal condition and also the minimal phase, which was very interesting because it was produced in the research line, and I had opportunity to understand some few interesting results, nice results actually, about the search area. So thanks anyway. So before I start my talk, I want to introduce some meeting, some singularity team meeting will be held in the northeast region of Brazil 2015. So the first one is the 10th mini workshop in singularity geometry and differential equation. It will be in Fortaleza City, Ceará State, from 11 to 13 of May. A short meeting, but everyone of course is invited. The second one is the Brazil Mexico second meeting on singularity and the third singularity meeting of Northeast. And so it will be from 8 to 17 of July. And we intend to do a school, to build a school from the first 3 days, from 8 to 10 of July. And we already have done some contact, and they've been on the accepted to do some mini course, and also we expected to have another mini course by Lee Dove about the talk that he already introduced in his talk, and maybe we'll have another more mini course. It should be something like this, geometry ones, topological ones, and algebraic ones. So everyone's invited to join us. And so let's move to the talk. So my starting point is the books. It's of course it's very well known. And so just to remind some few results of Luis Cisneros already showed some results on this city. I just started with some different remarks. So in the complex case, if you take a holomorphic function, we can assume that it sends it to zero. We will prove that the existence of a vibration for all spheres of readers more north centered of the origin, and the projection given by F over absolute value of F. It's very well known, and K epsilon is the intersection between the z-blocks of your function with the small sphere. And that's an idea about the picture. So the red line here is supposed to be the link. So you are finding the complement of this red line in the cycle to the unity cycle. And so in the ideal case, you consider, the ideal case, there is something strange here, but okay, anyway, So in the real case, I'm going to consider a polynomial map from R to RP. And also, we assume that f to 0 is equal to 0, and the dimension satisfies this condition. And also, we assume that the origin in Rn is a regular point, but in this case, there is nothing to do. You can just apply the implicit the theorem function, or 0 is as only the singlet. So, in this case, he proved the existence of a vibration. Now, in this city, what does he mean? So, for each epsilon small enough, you can find a eta, which is smaller than epsilon, such that in the restriction of your mapping, so this space, it is a vibration to the sphere, of the p minus 1 dimensional sphere of radius eta. So, in this case, the notation here means the closed ball. The closed ball center at the origin in Rn. So that's the idea about the picture in this case. So this is the total space of your formation. And it is also called the mirror of 2. And so in this case, if you just, if it, it's clear to see that if you just compose here with the projection pi of y equal to y over the sort of value of y, you get a vibration to the p minus 1 dimensional sphere. Okay, let me write this a little bit better. No? Okay. But it's okay to use it. Okay. Maybe one. Y over two of y to the unit sphere. So this composition, of course, is given by f over absolute value of f. So this case, to see that in the 2 you have the projection given by the canonical projection, that's like a complex case. And if you, so you know, let me just explain some point, the important point. So we will use the convenient vector field to inflate H2 to the sphere. And this is a radial vector field, and this way you get a vibration. Now from the component of a neighborhood, an open neighborhood of the link, the sphere to the sphere. But now there is no information about the projection. So you lost the information about the projection once you inflate the two to the sphere. That's how. So now, so since you assume that zero is already singlet, it's well known that the zero log here is transversal to all the small spheres. And it means that if you restrict your mapping f to the sphere, you see that zero is a regular value. It means that you can take a closed disk here, and then you take the image of this closed disk intersecting this sphere, you have a vibration. Actually, here is the punctured disk, but I'm talking about the whole disk, okay, with the origin. And of course, since this is convertible, you know that this is a trivial vibration. And now you can just remove the point here, the origin, and the respective fiber, you still have a vibration here. And you can do the same thing as I did in the 2. I mean, just compose with the retraction, and after that, the inflation. Okay? So now, again, you can see that the projection here is also given by the canonical ones. So, in the 2, and here, close to the link, it's okay. You have the same thing happen like in the complex case. Okay? But the problem is that if you consider the union of the 2 and this neighborhood here, what you have? You have a main photo of corner, of course. Since you already know that here, the two be transversal to the sphere. So you have the behavior of something like that. So the problem happens when you try to smooth such a space here, the union of both. Okay? Inflating to the sphere. Anyway, you can just now glue these two vibrations along the common boundary here. I forgot to explain, but in such an inflation, the vector field that Milo built, it is the identity here, the boundary. So in the boundary, everything keeps as before. So now you can just glue these two vibrations in a nice way along the boundary and take such vibration. So a vibration for the component of the new. The sphere, but of course you do not know who is the projection at all. Only here goes to the limb. So what does it mean? It means, according to a definition given by Boyega, it means that I do not want to explain all the definition because I will write another definition, a generalization of such definition. I will explain the generalization of course. So in this case, what you get is that the pair given by the sphere in the link is our NS pair. Anyway, it fits this central definition. So now now I will consider a definition in this paper here, published in 2013. So the definition is this one. The singular higher open group structure. What does it mean? It's a generalization of any aspect. I forgot to say, but it's of course it is well known. So if you take in such definition P equal to 2, it is called an open group structure, this structure. And also this condition here means that K is called a fiber link. So anyway, we just decide to pick one of them, we call it the open book structure. And singular hyper open book structure is clear because so now we are considering the pair given by the K and theta is this locally trivial smooth vibration. So the component of K in M is a analytic manifold of dimension n minus 1, but just to fit into the dimension of the sphere, you are considering the embedded sphere in RM. This is not so important. So, what else? So, K is a real smooth variety of dimension P. Dimension P here means that you have a regular part in K such that such regular set has a manifold. Has for dimension P. That's the meaning here. So, what else? Now, you are considering that there exists a neighborhood N in N of K such that such projection behaves in the neighborhood of N. I mean, in the complement of K, in the neighborhood N, like this composition. And it means that H is a smooth locally trivial vibration, and this is just the retraction composed with the inflection. I mean, we are retraction. We are retracting the budget disk to the boundary, and after that to inflate. So here, actually, of course, this composition means what I said. Once here the disk is often radius the delta or eta, doesn't matter. Okay? So anyway, if K is not singular and A is a trivial vibration, you are in the previous definition. So in this case we also call the K a singular byte, And the closure of the defiler of data is called the page of the singular open loop. Okay? So how to prove the existence of such structure? So we consider open neighborhood of the origin, U and F, a polynomial map under this condition, the dimension under this condition, and hold the square of distance transfer to the origin. And so now we consider these two sets. MF is called the minimum set. It is the points in your domain where the fiber of F is not transversal to the sphere. And MF over the absolute value of F, I mean the minimum set of the projection, is the point in the domain of F over the absolute value of F, where also this projection is not, the fiber of this projection is not transversal to the sphere. So, I think Cisneiro did a translation of the minimum set of the projection. It is the D-regular function, right? So, what was our result in such direction? So, in a joint paper with Chen and Mihai, we proved that for a polynomial map there, which satisfies this condition, I will explain geometrically what does it mean. If the minimum set is empty, then this pair is a singular higher open loop structure of the sphere. So it's not, I will explain the idea at this point, but it's the same idea that I explained before. So just of course we adapted the proof. What's the geometric mean? So now this black range here is the zero locus, and this yellow range means the minimum set of F. You may have a range of the minimum set V, but this condition means, okay, this intersection is empty, or it is the origin, and it means that now the closure of the complement of the minimum set, the closure of the difference of the minimum set in V, the topological closure here, it will intersect V only at the origin. It's something like we have like that. Okay, that's the geometric meaning of such condition. And so, example, it's well known, so, but holomorph function, any holomorph function satisfies this condition. Okay, of course, minimum proof before, if you track the minimum proof in the holomorph case, you see that before proof that F over absolute value of F is a vibration, he proved that F over absolute value of F from the sphere minus the link to the unit set cycle, it is a submission. And of course, this condition here means that your projection is a submission. And what else? So the. Okay. If you now consider a holomorphic mapping, it's well known that you can find a stratification of your zero locus in such a way that closer to the zero locus, your fiber is transversal to the sphere. It is called it's what we say that your function satisfies the tone AF condition. Tone AF condition implies such condition. Okay, so since we already have that since we have the tone AF condition, this condition is automatically satisfied anyway. So any holomorph function satisfies our condition. Our mixed function, which is region homogeneous, polar weighted homogeneous. What else? radial weighted homogeneous net from Rn to Rp under this condition, singular boxes included in V.
Would you remind me, what is the difference between radial and polar?
Okay, so actually, I think Gunsuoka, this is later, I don't remember right now, but I think Gunsuoka told something about such kind of function. So mixed function is a function where, okay, mixed function is okay.
Yes.
So what does mean radial homogeneous? You have a radial action, okay? And polar weight homogeneous, it means now a polar action, which means a polar action like in S1, cycle as well. So you have now action like radius and also like you have action in the direction of radius and also actions in the direction of cycle. Yes, so you have something like this way, rotation, and also this way. Okay? Of course, I forgot to write it here, but if you take a d-regular map on the Tom AF condition, of course, it implies our condition. So, anyway, global case. I'm still concerned about fragmentation of the big spheres. Okay, so our motivation this point was a paper by Nemichi and Zahai. That's the paper, and actually from that paper, we consider the definition of these two neural sets, okay? And so he considered the neural set of the function. So he considered, a polynomial or holomorphic function. And holomorphic just to say that, okay, there is no conjugation here, okay? It's not like mixed function. In the neural set, the gradient here is the conjugation of the complex gradient, okay? And also, he considered this set, it's called the asymptotic set. It is built by the values of C, where you have a limit of tangents in the neural set, going to infinity. So, on that paper, they proven that if your asymptotic set satisfies this condition, this notation here means that for all R big enough, for all radius big enough, okay? So this projection is a smooth locally trivial fragmentation, where now has in the local case, KR means the limit at infinity of F. It is known that the topological type of this set is well defined. Anyway, like the local case. So, in this case, we say that F admits minimal fragmentation at infinity. So, this condition here, it was also defined. I mean, once your function satisfies this condition, we say that your function is semi-table. Okay. Prove a generalization in this case, in this paper, which was accepted for publication in Mathematics Scandinavia, but consider also these two conditions. It's the same if you see, like in the local ones, the same idea. And what would we have in this case? So, F now is a polynomial map, and we are considering these two conditions. Just call it condition 1 and 2. What does it mean? It means that this set now is bound. And also this set is bound. That's if you understood the situation, the local case, you see that it is completely natural to ask these two conditions. So what does it mean? So under these two conditions, we can prove the same result. So the existence of singular hybrid open loop on the big scheme. That was the point in this case. So what is the geometrical idea? The intersection, I mean, the section is bound, and also this guy is bound, it just means that. So for the first one, the first one means that such intersection between this guy and the complement of V in this set, the closure, the topological closure of the complement of V in this set, and V does not intersect anymore after a big ball. So everything happened into a big ball here. So after such big ball, it may intersect again only at V. But of course we are in a free space. There is no intersection in such in the free space. So again, we can find a kind of cone-shaped neighborhood, we call the denoted by N here, in such a way that here the fiber is also transversal to the sphere. Of course, this neighborhood may be twin and twin when it goes to infinity, but doesn't matter. So this way we can develop the same idea we did in the local case, just of course doing the convenient adaptation. Okay? So example. So again, any complex polynomial function is a holomorphic Lanczmann conjugation under semi-tame condition. Also means polynomial, which is radial homogeneous and polar weighted homogeneous. Radial weighted homogeneous map, now real map, under this condition, the same thing you have. And also means function of type f bar, which also satisfies the same condition. So just to give you some example, which does not come from real polynomial. For complex C, okay? Anyway, now I will explain an idea to unify these two vibrations. Vibration is small sphere and big sphere. So what we consider? So in this case, we consider a smooth closed semi-jacquard manifold of dimension n, which is embedded in some bigger n, and a map f from the bigger n to Rp. Again, we are considering these conditions for the solution. Okay? F, we can just suppose that it is a smooth semi-jacquard map, but C2 is enough. Okay? And V, as before, is the zero logs of your map. So, in this case, we denote by F bar, F over absolute value of F, is C. Of course, you see that is the same idea we consider in the local case. Okay? VWF, we just call the relative link. Just put a name to this set. The intersection of the zero locus in them. And F bar, the distinction of F bar to W. And of course, you have to remove the intersection of the zero locus in that. So now we consider again, you see that it is completely natural what I will explain. So in this case, this set here means the critical point of F visited to that. And sigma omega, sorry, F bar is the critical set. The critical point, sorry, of F bar is still to that. So, under the notation, we consider these two conditions. Almost, we can see that it's almost the same, except for the fact, of course, now we are as this center. This is the point to unify those two vibrations. Okay? So, so in this case, we just say that F satisfies the generalized conditions A and B. And so now, in a joint work with Patrick Chen and Andrade, we prove that under conditions condition B, there is too much S. So under condition A, condition B hold, even if now this map is as most locally trivial fiber. So Now you just considered W has a semi-algebraic meaningful. There is no big weight to small, small values. It's enough to take such kind of foundation. And so, application. Let's see the local case. So, in the local case, oh, okay. In the local case, has we already saw, we have a kind of home neighborhood here where this set, this guy here, does not intersect anymore the zero logs. What does it mean? It means, of course, it means that there's a Portuguese word here. So therefore, you have such condition. Of course, because now the intersection of, I mean, the topological closure of this guy here, you can just compare with the topological closure with MF minus V. And of what if you assume, if you assume now that if you are considered now a gen of polynomial map like that under this condition, in this condition you can just now see that both conditions apply our new condition. Yeah, implies these two conditions. This one is of course, because when you say that the minimal set of projection is A, is the same here, the singular set of F bar in W is A, the same thing. And this condition is exactly what the picture is telling you. So, okay, go. Sorry. Okay. Yeah. So now this the first condition is exactly what the picture is telling you here. So, what does it mean? It means that under those old conditions, we can just consider now W has a small sphere, and under those two conditions, we already have these two conditions for a fixed sphere. Okay. So for any of course fix the small sphere. And so it implies oops. Okay. So it implies the you can prove this theorem the same way we did like in the local case. The same idea. Just of course we have to adapt some things, and so what we can say in the global case? The global case now. Okay, let's come back to the B. Now we are considering that. Yeah, so now you can just consider a polynomial map under these two conditions. So again, this condition implies our condition as well. And this one is the same idea that we did in the local case. You can just look at this picture again, or this, okay. In this picture here, The same, I mean, you can prove a more general vibration result without look at small sphere or big sphere. That's the point in this part of the talk. But what else we can say? So now we consider a canonical projection, the target space, pi from RT to RT minus 1. And let's denote G by such composition. And the point here is, okay, if we assume that F satisfies conditions A and B, what we can say about G? It is possible to prove that G also satisfies these two conditions. So it's such kind of conditions, it's kind of course, semi-algebraic condition. It means that after projection, you keep such conditions. Doesn't matter if you have small sphere, big sphere. That's the point. Okay? So, now, of course, you have a vibration. If you assume that F satisfies those two conditions, and P is at least 3, you have a vibration for F bar and also vibration for G bar. Okay. I will denote by NF the fiber of F bar and NG the fiber of G bar. And it's possible to prove that, again, if F satisfies those two conditions, then the fiber of F bar and the fiber of G bar are homotopy equivalent. That was an interesting result to us. So in this point, I think, of course, we already proved such a result for isolated singularity. And for non-isolated singularity, the local case under those two conditions. So it was natural to ask such kind of property here. Okay? So you can just reduce now the study of the topological type of a fiber to the case for the case of P equal to 2, I mean mapping over S1. And what we can say also in this case. So if you just project now for the coordinate function, you can look at these two sets. So the points in that where you can just take one coordinate function, J, or Fj, and you can look at these two sets. The points in that where Fj is positive and the points where Fj is negative. And what is also possible to prove? Okay, if F satisfies the generalized conditions in D, then for Nj, these three sets are homotopy equivalent. So now we can just reduce the understanding of the homotopy type of the fiber to one coordinate function. That's the point. Of course, in this case, the dimension is right. Okay, the dimension of the fiber, let's say, is right. Okay, but if you just understand the homotopy type of the fiber of such kind of fiber here, you know the fiber of your minimum vibration for small sphere or big sphere, if you are considering the local or global case. That's the point. So, what else is possible to prove? We consider also, okay, if F satisfies those two conditions, now I'm just considering W has a N minus 1 dimension. Just for you can just think W has the embedded sphere in Rn, in Rn, okay? So, in this case, it's possible to prove that the difference between the other characteristics of the respective relative links of J and F satisfy this condition. This problem was also interesting to us, because it clearly says that the other characteristics of fiber It is a natural obstruction for the links, the respective links of the projections being homotopy equivalent. So that's one way to understand such kind of form. Of course, if the two links are homotopy equivalent, the order characteristic of the fiber is zero. And this being, if it's not zero, it's a trivial polygon. So, yeah, I think I should stop over here. And, okay.
Thanks, speaker.